Hi, I'm Mr. Hassan. Welcome to the seventh installment of our Flipped Classroom. Today, we're going to be covering lessons 3.7, Rational Numbers and the Coordinate Plane. We're going to be in our textbook only today, so you only need your textbook. And we're going to start on page 123. So again, in your textbook, page 123. I'm going to refocus the camera. See you in a minute. Ground control's a major Tom. Okay, so here we are on page 123 of our textbook, lesson 3.7, Rational Numbers and the Coordinate Plane. So as you can see at the top of the page, there's a lot of vocabulary this week. So we're going to read through here and make sure we're paying attention to all of the highlighted bold-faced words. A coordinate plane is a plane formed by a horizontal number, a horizontal number line called the x-axis, that intersects a vertical number line called the y-axis. The axis intersect at zero on both number lines. The point where the axes intersect is the origin. So if we come over here to the right and take a look, here is a coordinate plane. This entire picture is a picture of a coordinate plane. The x-axis runs horizontal, the y-axis runs vertical, and where the x and y-axis intersect is called the origin. Let's look at the second paragraph. An ordered pair is a pair of numbers, such as 3, 2, that can be used to locate a point on the coordinate plane. The first number is the x-coordinate. It tells the distance to move left or right from the origin. The second number is the y-coordinate. It tells the distance to move up or down from the origin. The ordered pair for the origin is 0, 0. So 0 on the x-axis and 0 on the y-axis is going to be here, the origin point, where the x-axis intersects with the y-axis. If I were to look at points 3, 2, I would be 3 points to the right, 2 points up, to find the coordinate or the plotted point for the coordinate or the ordered pair 3, 2, or the coordinates 3, 2. All right, I'm going to slide the book up here a little bit. Okay, so unlock the problem. A screen in a video game shows a coordinate plane. The points P, Q, R, and S represent treasure chests. Write the ordered pair for each treasure chest's location. Find the location of each point. To find the coordinates of point P, start at the origin. So here's P. We're going to start at the origin. How do I get to point P? That's the little red point here in the picture of the treasure chest. Move 2 units to the, well, I got to start here. I got to move 1, 2 units to the left. And move blank units up. So here I am 2 units to the left, and I go 1, 2, 3 units up. Point P is located at -2, 3. Point Q is located, well, here's point Q. Again, I start at my origin point, and I'm going to have to move left again, 1, 2, 3 points. So point Q is -3 on the x-axis, but on the y-axis, it's down 1, 2, 3. So as you can see, down is also going to be negative, so it's a -3. Point R, here's point R. Point R, I have to go to the right on my x-axis. I go 1, 2, 3, 4 points to the right, so that's going to be a +4. And how many do I have to go up? 1, 2, 3. To the right, positive, up, also positive. Point S is located, well, here I am, it's right on my x-axis, so that's going to be a 0. And I have to go down 1, 2 points, so that's a -2.
A kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to see you obviously do not adore. I get no kick in a plane flying too high.
All right, example. Graph and label the point on the coordinate plane. A says 2, negative one half. So I'm going to start at my origin point here. It says 2 for the x-axis, so I'm going to move 1, 2. And then it says negative 1 half. So I'm going to come down to negative 1 half, make my mark, and label it with A. So I had to move blank units to the right. Well, I moved 2 units to the right, and move 1 half unit down. Let's look at B. B says negative 0.5 and 0. Start at the origin. I'm going to slide my book here so we can see it a little bit better. The x coordinate is blank. Well, the x coordinate is negative. So we want to move to the left unit. Oh, no. That's not right. We want to move 0.5 unit to the left. The y-coordinate is 0, so the point lies on the x-axis. I don't have to go up or down my y-axis. I'm going to stay right on my x-axis. And it's only 0.5 units to the left, so that's going to be right here. Point B. All right, point C. Point C says 2.5. I'm going to slide up so we can read it. 2.5 and 3/4. So if we were to start at the origin, we're going to move 2.5 units to the right on the x-axis. And we're going to move 3/4 unit down. So let's go up to our graph and do that. So again, my points were 2.5 and 3/4. So I'm going to come over here to 2.5, and I'm going to go up to 3/4. 3/4 is going to be right between 1/2 and 1. I'm going to plot it, and I'm going to label it C. Now I need to go back here to C because I realized that I made a mistake. It's a positive number, 3/4, so I'm going to go unit. And then I'm going to go up. I don't want to go down there because it's a positive. Sorry about that. All right, let's look at D. D says start at the origin, move blank units to the blank. Well, let's look at our plots here. -1.25 or -1.25 and -1.75 or -1.75. So we want to move 1.25 units to the left because it's negative, and move 1.75 units down also because it's negative. So let's go up here to our graph and label that. So again, it's -1.25. That's going to be right here between 1.5 and 1. So I go to the left 1.25. And I'm going to go down 1.75. So there's 1.75. is going to be somewhere right around there. And this is point D. All right, let's slide down the book and check out show and share. All right, show and share. Number one, write the ordered pair for point J. Start at the origin. Well, here's point J on my graph. If I start at the origin, I'm going to have to move blank units to the blank. So here's my point. Here's the origin. I want to move 1.5 units, so 1.5 units to the left, and blank units blank. Well, here's, again, we're at 1.5 units. How many do I have to go up? There's 1. There's 2.5 units, so 2.5 units up. my ordered pair is going to be negative 1.5 and 2.5 for point J. Let's look at number two. Number two says K. So let's find K on our chart. Here's K. So for K, I've got to go right one and down negative 1.5. So it's going to be 1 and negative 1.5 are going to be my ordered pair for K. Let's take a look at L. Here's L. L, I've got to go left 2, so it's going to be negative 2. How many do I have to go down? So here's 1. I'm just past 1.5, so it's going to be 1.75. It's going to be negative 1.75 because I had to go down. And point M. Here's point M. I'm going to go right 1, so that's my x-axis number, 1. How many do I have to go up? I don't have to go up any, and I don't have to go down any. So that's right on the y-axis, and it's going to be 0. All right, we're going to take a minute here to refocus our books. I'll see you guys in a minute on page 125. So here we are on the page of 125 here at the top of the page. Let's look at number 5. Number 5 says the directions first. The directions say graph and label the point on the coordinate plane. So number 5, P. P is negative 2.5 and 2. So let's go over here to the graph. We need to go to negative 2.5, so that's going to be left. There's 2.5 and then up 2. For point P. We're going to label that P. 6 says for point Q, negative 2 and 1/4. So here's my 0. Again, I'm coming left because I have a negative number, so negative 2. And then I'm going to go up 1/4. And 1/4 is going to be about halfway between the 1/2 mark and 0. And I'm going to label that Q. Number 7 says R, 0 and 1.5. So here I am at 0, and then I'm going to come up to 1.5. And there's R. S says negative 1 and negative 1/2. So if it's a negative number, I come left 1, and then I've got to go down for my negative 1/2 on the y-axis, and I'm labeling that S. T says 1 and 1/2 and negative 2. So I'm going to go right 1 1/2 and then down negative 2. There's my mark for T. Excuse me. 10 says U, 0.75 and 1.25. So as we know from our decimal chapter, 0.075 is the same as 3/4, and 0.25 or 1 25 hundredths is the same as 1 1/4. So I'm going to go right 3/4, which is about here, halfway between 1/2 and 1, and up 1 1/4. So up 1 1/4, which is about halfway between 1 1/2, and I'm going to mark that with U. V is negative 0.5 and 0, and 0.5, as we know, is the same as 1/2, so this is negative 1/2 and 0. Negative 1/2 is here, and 0 stays on the x-axis there, and this is going to be point V, getting a little crowded in my coordinate plane there. 12 is going to be point W, is 2 and 0. So I'm going to go right 2 and then 0. I don't go up or down any. I'm, again, going to be on the x-axis. And this is W. Ay, ay, ay. Keep breaking my pencil point.
point W. And the last one here, number 13, is point X at 0 and negative 2. So here I'm at 0, and then I just have to go down to negative 2, and I'm at X. All right, that wraps up our lesson today, lesson 3.7, rational numbers and the coordinate plane. I hope you guys enjoyed the lesson. I'll see you again next week for lesson 3.8. Mr. Hassan, signing off.